Terriers are a specific group and type of dog that were originally bred to dig and hunt for prey, like foxes, moles, badgers, and rats. Their name originates in the Latin word terra and means earth, although some people joke that the word terrier actually comes from the word terror. There are many sizes and shapes of breeds in the terrier group, but there's one thing, which is that feisty, mischievous personality and an energetic nature. In this video, we have listed the 10 most interesting terrier dog breeds. Before we start, what would you name this male puppy? Let us know in the comments. Number 10, Airedale Terrier. All terriers think they're kings or queens, but this dog has a better claim to the throne than most. Not only does the Airedale Terrier come first alphabetically, but with a height of about 23 inches at the shoulder, it stands taller than any other terrier breed. This has led the Airedale to be nicknamed King of the Terriers. The breed is particularly known for its courage in World War I, when Airedales were used by the British to carry messages and find wounded soldiers. Airedales can be a lot to handle given their size and independent terrier temperament. Number 9. American Hairless Terrier. The Hairless Terrier is the new, bald kid on the block, having only emerged in 1972. It all started when a hairless pup appeared in a litter of rat terriers. That dog was bred to create this still-rare terrier breed with no coat. Allergy sufferers? This might be the terrier for you. If you're getting one of these dogs, don't forget to buy a wardrobe for it as well. Hairless dogs tend to get cold and, perhaps more importantly, need protection from the sun. Number 8. Bedlington Terrier. Like many terrier breeds, the Bedlington Terrier was named after a place in England. In this case, it's the mining town of Bedlington, where the breed was employed as a ratter. With a dash of Whippet and Otterhound in its bloodline, this small dog doesn't look like the typical terrier, but when you see it in action, you get it. These dogs take on a lamb-like appearance when groomed for show. As with poodles, the frou-frou hairdo is optional if the dog is a family pet. Number 7. Cairn Terrier. You can't get more terrier than a Cairn Terrier. This fearsome little breed originates in the Scottish Highlands and takes its name from the stone mounds called cairns, where the dogs were tasked with hunting rodents. Modern Cairn Terriers maintain a strong prey drive, but their usual gig these days is being a loving member of the family. These dogs have a coat that needs to be periodically hand-stripped to maintain its wiry texture. That said, if you're not going to show the dog and don't mind a softer coat, standard dog grooming is just fine. Number 6. Dandy Dinmont Terrier. With its long body, stubby legs, large head, and fuzzy topknot, the Dandy Dinmont Terrier is one of the more oddball terrier breeds. It's also one of the rarest. If the name rings a bell, you've probably seen them in a televised dog show. That, or you're a fan of Scottish novelist Sir Walter Scott, whose character, Dandy Dinmont, gave the breed its name. It's not just their unusual appearance that sets these dogs apart from other terriers. They're also said to be less hyper and have a baritone bark rather than the usual high-pitched yap. Number 5. Kerry Blue Terrier. When people say terriers come in many different forms, the Kerry Blue Terrier is one of the dogs they have in mind. The bluish coat is obviously the standout feature of this breed, which is named after the county of Kerry in Ireland. But these dogs aren't just about looks. The breed is woven into Irish folklore and history, and over the years has had jobs ranging from exterminator to police dog. Kerry Blue Terriers are great family dogs, but have a strong prey drive and tend to be aggressive with other dogs. The best cure for that is early socialization. Number 4. West Highland White Terrier. The West Highland White Terrier, or Westie, looks very much like a bleached version of its cousin, the Cairn Terrier. The white color was likely bred into these dogs to prevent them from being mistaken for foxes when on the hunt. Now, it's more of a fashion statement, and no doubt a big reason for the breed's popularity as a house pet. Westies are playful, quirky, and just plain adorable. But be advised, they don't always like to cuddle. They're independent dogs and may not tolerate the restrained feeling of being held or sitting in a lap. Number 3. Sealyham Terrier. As a breed, the Sealyham Terrier has had its ups and downs. From its humble origin in Wales as an otterhound, it rose to become the most fashionable dog in Hollywood, owned by such A-listers as Elizabeth Taylor, Alfred Hitchcock, and Cary Grant. But fame, as is often the case, was fleeting, and the breed is now one of the lesser-known terriers around. The rarity of these dogs is hard to fathom, as they make great family pets and are adaptable to different environments. Number 2. Miniature Schnauzer. This breed doesn't fit the terrier profile in many ways. It doesn't have terrier in its name, nor a background with origins in England, Ireland, or Scotland. But what the miniature Schnauzer does have is a feisty terrier personality, an athletic build, and a face that's to die for. Put it all together, and it's no wonder Minis are among the most popular dogs on the planet. This is one of the more people-pleasing of the Terrier breeds. While Terriers are famous for having minds of their own, miniature Schnauzers are often focused on their owners, and with their high intelligence, can be trained to do tricks with relative ease. Number 1. Manchester Terrier. These smooth-coated Terriers were originally bred to kill rats, a job that was much needed in the 19th century in places such as Manchester, England. They're known for their speed and agility, and for being lively and fun members of the family. There is both a standard Manchester Terrier, which can weigh up to 22 pounds, and a toy Manchester Terrier, which tops out at 12 pounds. This breed nearly went extinct after World War II, and is one of the less common Terrier breeds around. As a result, you may need to make a road trip if you want to connect with a breeder. That concludes our video of the 10 most interesting Terrier dog breeds. Which one did you find the most interesting? Let us know in the comments. And if you like this video, then subscribe and turn on notifications so you'll be the first to know when a new video comes out. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.